وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى Today we're going to cover the tafsir of Ayatul Kursi. And the reason why I chose to do the tafsir of Ayatul Kursi is because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in the hadith, أَعْظَمُ آيَةٍ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ That Ayatul Kursi is the greatest verse in the Qur'an. There is no verse in the Qur'an greater than Ayatul Kursi. Now this kind of amazed me because Ayatul Kursi does not have the most letters. In the sense, it's not the ayah that has the most letters, the most huruf. The ayah that has the most huruf is Ayatul Dain. Ma'a dhalika Ayatul Kursi is greater. So the question is why? So mufadala, the reason why Ayatul Kursi is greater than any ayah in the Quran is مفاضلة باعتبار الألفاظ والمعاني لا باعتبار من تكلم به The virtue of Ayatul Kursi is from two angles باعتبار الألفاظ والمعاني In terms of the wording, it's better than any wording in the Quran And we'll see why والمعاني in terms of the meaning that is in Ayatul Kursi is not in any ayah in the Quran And because of those two reasons, Ayatul Kursi, there's no ayah like it لا باعتبار من تكلم به We're not looking at it in the angle of who spoke it Because all of the Quran, whose speech is it? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's speech But the reason why Ayatul Kursi is greater than any ayah in the Quran Is باعتبار الألفاظ والمعاني and the meaning that are in it So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to prove that in the tafsir today inshallah ta'ala Let's first of all cover The virtues pertaining to Ayatul Kursi, the virtues that are in Ayatul Kursi. But before I go into that, my beloved brothers and sisters, it is very vital and very important that a person stands over the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the gems and the beauty that is in the Quran, you will not find it in any other place. Wallahi, you won't find it anywhere else. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامُ الشَّاطِبِيُّ He says in his حِرْزُ الْأَمَانِ وَوَجْهُ التَّهَانِي He says, وَإِنَّ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ أَوْثَقُ شَافِعٍ وأغنى غناء واهبا متفضلا وخير جليس لا يمل حديثه وترداده يزداد فيه تجملا That the Quran is خير جليس لا يمل حديثه The Quran is the best thing to sit with لا يمل حديثه Whilst you're reading the Quran you will never get bored of what it's telling you وترداده The repetition of the Quran يزداد فيه تجملا Beauty will increase for you The more you read it The more you recite the Qur'an, the beauty will increase. Al-Shatibi says that in his kitab, حِرْزُ الْأَمَانِ وَوَجْهُ التَّهَانِي. He also says in his other kitab, عَقِيلَةُ أَتْرَابِ الْقَصَائِدِ. He says, وَعَلَمْ بِأَنَّ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ أَوْثَقُ شَافِعٍ وَعَلَمْ بِأَنَّ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ خُصَّ بِمَا تَاهَ الْبَرِيَّةُ عَنْ إِتْيَانِهِ ظُهَرًا مَنْ قَالَ صَرْفَتُهُمْ مَعَ حَثِّ نُصْرَتِهِمْ وَفْرُ الدَّوَاعِي وَلَمْ يَسْتَنْصِرُ نُصَرًا كَمْ مِنْ بَدَائِعَ لَمْ تُوجَدْ بَلَاغَتُهَا إِلَّا لَدَيْهِمْ وَكَمْ طُولَ الزَّمَانِ تُرَى He says, وَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ خُصَّ بِمَا تَاهَ الْبَرِيَّةُ عَنْ إِتْيَانِهِ ظُهَرًا That the Qur'an has inside it and the things that are in it تَاهَ الْبَرِيَّةُ The creation have become tired and effortless عَنْ إِتْيَانِهِ ظُهَرًا To come something like this كَمْ مِنْ بَدَائِعَ لَمْ تُوجَدْ بَلَاغَتُهَا إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ وَكَمْ طُولَ الزَّمَانِ تُرَى The gems And the balagha and the eloquency that one will find in the book of Allah, you will not find it anywhere else. This is specific and it's unique for who? It is specific and it's unique for the book of Allah. But because we have become distant from the book of Allah, and we've abandoned the book of Allah, we don't receive that. Or we don't see that. Ayatul Kursi has many virtues that have come regarding it. One of the virtues is Nabiullahi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala anhu in the hadith of Sahih Muslim. Ubay said, Qala li Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger said to me, Ya Abu al-Mundhir, Ubay. His kunya is Abu al-Mundhir. Why did the Prophet choose to call him Abu al-Mundhir? Ibn al-Qayyim says, Rahimahullah, Lutful Khitab wa Husn al-Tawaddud. The reason why he chose to say, Ya Abu al-Mundhir, is to bring his heart close. The Prophet said to him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ayyu ayatin fi kitabillahi a'zam. Abu al-Mundhir, Ubay, do you know the greatest ayah in the book of Allah? Ubay then responded by saying, Allahu wa Rasulu a'lam. And the Sahabas, you always find this from them. When they don't know something and they are unaware of it, they always say, Allahu wa Rasulu a'lam. Walidhalika, Abdullah ibn Hajj al-Shinqiti says in his kitab Maraqi al-Su'ud, Limubtaghi al-Ruqi wa-Su'ud, he says, وَالْكُلُّ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَنَاحِ الْأَرْبَعَةِ يَقُولُ لَا أَدْرِي فَكُنْ مُتَّبِعَةً. That you see the scholars, they generally say, I don't know. When they don't know a matter, so follow them in that. When you don't know something, say, Allahu A'lam. But Ubay knew it. But the humbleness of the companions, he said, Allahu wa Rasulu A'lam. And then the messenger asked him again. And then he said, Allahu wa Rasulu A'lam. And then the messenger asked him on the third occasion. And then he said to him, Ayatul Kursi. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. فَضَرَبَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ صَدْرِي. He said that the Prophet hit my chest. فَقَالَ لِهِ, he said to me, لِيَهْنِكَ الْعِلْمَ أَبَ الْمُنْذِرِ. He said, may knowledge be made easy and simple and simplified for you. May Allah treasure you with knowledge. So the Prophet made dua for Ubay. Now my question, brothers, is, there are how many verses in the Quran, brothers? 6,200 and something. Ma'adhalika, Ubay specifically knew ayah was the best ayah in the Quran. How did he know? We'll see later. The Sahabas already pondered on the Quran and understood it. The second, walidhalika, this Ibn al-Qayyim in his kitab Zad al-Ma'ad, he mentions that by knowing Ayatul Kursi and your knowledge of Ayatul Kursi increasing will increase the fear and the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He brought the kalam of Ahmad ibn Asim that he said, Man kana billahi a'raf, kana lahu akhwaf. Anyone who knows Allah more, he will fear Allah more. Ayatul Kursi teaches you about Allah that which no other surah will, and no other ayah will. Ibn al-Qayyim said, Man kana billahi a'raf, kana lahu akhwaf, wa li'ibadatihi atlab, wa an ma'asiyatihi ab'ad. Anyone who knows Allah more, he fears Allah more, and he more looks to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa an ma'asiyatihi ab'ad. And he's most distanced from, he's more distanced from the sinning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also the other hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, that shows the virtue of Ayatul Kursi is the hadith of Abi Umamah al-Bahili. Nasa'i narrated in it in two places. In his kitab Amal al-Yawm wal-Layla and is also his Sunan al-Kubra. Al-Imam al-Nasa'i has two Sunan. He has Sunan al-Kubra and the other one which is called Mujtaba. In his Sunan al-Kubra, Al-Imam al-Nasa'i, he narrated it that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Man qara'a Ayatul Kursi fi duburi kulli salatin لَمْ يَمْنَعْهُنَّ مِنْ دُخُولِ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا أَنْ يَمُوتِ. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ قَرَأَ, anyone who recites Ayatul Kursi fi duburi kulli salah, he recites Ayatul Kursi after every single prayer, the person recites, what does he recite? Ayatul Kursi. لَمْ يَمْنَعْهُنَّ, nothing prevents him مِنْ دُخُولِ الْجَنَّةِ, in entering Jannah, nothing will stop you from it. Except what? إِلَّا أَنْ يَمُوتَ, except to die. All that is between you and entering Jannah is death. If you read what? If you read Ayatul Kursi, دُبْرِ كُلِّ صَلَاةِ. وَلِذَلِكَ Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions in his Majmu'u al-Fatawa, and he also mentions it in his kitab, بَيَانُ الدَّلِيلِ فِي بُطْلَانِ التَّحَلِيلِ, that if the غَالِب أَحْوَالِ الشَّخْصِ, the majority of the times you read Ayatul Kursi, you will fall under this hadith, even if there are some occasions that you didn't do it. That the kul here, fi duburi kulli salah, he said it means غالب الأحوال, the majority of the situations. That if times you miss it, no problem. ولذلك Ibn al-Qayyim says, وَبَلَغَنِي عَنْ شَيْخِنَ عَبِ الْعَبَّاسِ Ibn Taymiyyah تَقَدَّسَ اللَّهُ رُوحَهُ أَنَّهُ قَالَ. Ibn al-Qayyim said, due to this hadith, it reached me that Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah used to say, ما تركت عقب كل صلاة. I did not leave off after every single prayer reciting Ayatul Kursi. Ibn Taymiyyah said, I never left it. So this hadith, what does it show us? That entering Jannah Ayatul Kursi is a key to it. The third virtue, inshallah ta'ala, is the hadith, the famous hadith that Bukhari narrated this hadith in his Sahih, mu'allaqan, bisigat al-jazm. Like in Hafidh ibn Hajar mentions in Fathul Bari, that three scholars, they brought it mawsulan. Number one is al-Imam al-Nasa'iyu, al-Isma'ili, and Abu Nu'aym. Al-Asbahaniyu, three of these scholars, they brought that hadith mawsulan, even though it's mu'allaq in Sahih al-Bukhari. The qissa of Abu Hurairah, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَكَلَنِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ at Zakat al-Fitri, that the Prophet entrusted me, gave me responsibility over Zakat al-Fitri. I was told to look after the Zakat al-Fitri. And a man came to him, and when the man came to him, he saw him stealing the Zakat. So Abu Hurairah grabbed him, and the man cried. He said, I'm a faqir, my children. He begged him, please let me go, I will never come back again. Abu Hurairah let him go. In the morning, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Abu Hurairah, ما فعل أما كيف كان أسيرك البارحة? How was your prisoner last night? What did he do? And then he said, Ya Rasulullah, he came, he tried to take the zakat money, I grabbed him, and then I let him go because he begged me, he cried. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, he's lying to you, he's going to come back. So this happened three different occasions. The third occasion when Abu Hurairah grabbed him, he said to him, let me go. Abu Hurairah said, I'm not going to let you go this time. He said, دعني أعلمك كلمات. Let me teach you كلمات ينفعك الله به. I will teach you something ينفعك الله بها, that Allah is going to benefit you greatly with. And Abu Hurairah was a person who loved knowledge. So he listened to him. When he listened to him, he took that. And then he came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he had told him what he said to him. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, what did he say to you? He said to me, إِذَا أَوَيْتَ إِلَىٰ فِرَاشِكَ, if you come to your bed, you intend to go to your bed, فَقْرَ آيَةَ الْكُرْسِي, recite آيَةُ الْكُرْسِي. اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّمُ, read it. حَتَّى تَخْتِمَ الْآيَةَ, until you finish off the ayah, read it all in its totality. Don't leave anything. فَإِنَّكَ لَن تَزَالَ, because if you do it, you will remain. Remember, لَن تَزَالَ, نَفْيُ إِثْبَات, صح? لَن is نَفْيُ, تَزَالَ فِيهِ مَعْنَى النَّفْيُ, نَفْيُ إِثْبَات. So it means you will remain. That's how we have to translate it. عَلَيْكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَافِظٌ وَلَا يَقْرَبَنَّكَ شَيْطَانُ حَتَّى تُصْبِح. Because of that night, a recitation of Ayatul Kursi, that whole night Allah is going to protect you. And no shaitan can come anywhere close to you. Now some people took from this hadith that you're allowed to take knowledge from those who are misguided and innovators, because they say Abu Hurairah took from shaitan. And that is incorrect. لماذا? Because first of all, Abu Hurairah, when Abu Hurairah came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, he said, Za'ama. This man claimed, Za'ama, annahu yu'allimuni kalimat, that he's going to teach me words of benefit. And Za'ama, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? Bi'sa matiyatu rajuli za'amu. That the worst riding beast that a person can take is to say Za'ama. Za'ama is something to claim, it's something that has no base. زعم الذين كفروا أن لا يبعثوا قل بلى وربي لتبعثن ثم لتنبؤن بما عملتم وذلك على الله يسير. زعم is what? زعم مطية الكذب. It means something that's not true. ولذلك the poet, he said, إذ الفتى حسب اعتقاده رفع وكل ما لم يعتقد لم ينتفع. A student of knowledge, from him to take from an innovator means he has to open his heart towards him. And if the person is somebody you're saying, I'm going to be careful, I won't take his misguidance from him, you're going to be careful, I'm going to take the misguidance, I'm going to protect myself from taking misguidance from him, then that goes against the essence of a student towards a teacher. Because the student has to open his heart to his teacher to take everything from him. Also, the fact that Abu Hurairah didn't know this was Iblis. And so he didn't know this was Shaytan. He did not know this was Shaytan. He verified it with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Abu Hurairah took it from who? The Messenger, not from the Shaytan. He didn't take it because Shaytan said it. He took it because the Prophet told him, alayhi salatu wa salam. But the benefit that we take from the hadith is the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is innahu sadaqaka wa huwa kadhub. That he's a liar, he's a compulsive liar, but he told you the truth, which is true. That if you do recite Ayatul Kursi, Allah will protect you subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the question here is, we said that Ayatul Kursi has got all of these virtues. How are we going to prove that Ayatul Kursi has virtue over everything, over every ayah in the Quran? I said, bi'atibari al-alfaz and bi'atibari al-ma'ani, in terms of the wording and in terms of the meaning. Let me start with, in terms of the wording, because that's shorter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name, whether it be a ism zahir, or whether it be a dhamir, whether that dhamir is bariz or mustatir, it has come in Ayatul Kursi 21 times. 21 times Allah has been mentioned in Ayatul Kursi. Either ism zahir, an apparent noun, or dhamir, bariz or mustatir. The two types of dhamir. 21 times it's been mentioned in the Quran. 21 times it's been mentioned in Ayatul Kursi. No other ayah in the Quran has this. Where is it? Look at the ayah. Allah says, Allahu, lafzul jalala, a'raful ma'arif. Allahu, that's the first one. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa. Two, which is a dhamir, bariz. Three, al-hayy. Four, al-qayyum. Ta'khuduhu, that ha in there. Ta'khuduhu, that ha is a dhamir mutasil. And that's five. Six, so Allah, huwa, al-hayy, al-qayyum. Ta'khuduhu, lahu. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ لَهُ, that ha in there is referring to Allah. عِنْدَهُ, that ha in there is referring to Allah. بِإِذْنِهِ, that ha in there is referring to Allah. يَعْلَمُ, the fa'il which is mustatir, تَقْدِيرُهُ هُوَ, is Allah. That's nine. 10. عِلْمُهُ is what? The ha in there is what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. شَاءَ, the fa'il which is تَقْدِيرُهُ هُوَ. Sha'a, the fa'il is mustatir wujuban, which is what? Huwa, Allah. That's 11. 12. Kursiyuhu, the ha in there is Allah. 3. Ya'uduhu, the ha in there is Allah. Hifdhuhuma. Hifdhuhuma is a bit hard to find. This is a tricky one. Hifdhuhuma, because hifd is a mazdar. It's a verbal noun. Hifd is what? Is the mazdar. And the grammarians, they say, وَالْمَزْدَرُ يَعْمَلُ عَمَلَ فِعْلِهِ سَبْعَةٌ مِنْهَا الْمَزْدَرُ. Seven things can do the job of a verb. From them is the verbal noun, which is the مَزْدَر. So from them is what? From them is a verb. So what do we say? أَنْ يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا أَيْ أَنْ يَحْفَظَهُمَا أَنْ يَحْفَظَهُمَا. The an, which is the mazdariya, and the fi'l mudari'. So if yahfaduhuma, the huma is referring to the sama and the ard. Hifd is a fi'l, because I said the mazdar does the amal of the fi'l. Hifd is doing the action of a verb. Who's doing this verb then? Who's doing this verb of protecting the sama and the ard? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's 14. Number 15 is وَلَا يَؤُدُوهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ. The huwa is 15. 6 is al-ali. 16. 17 is azim. 18 is al-hayy and al-qayyum and al-ali al-azim, the mubtada which is muqaddar, that is hidden in each and every one of them, because all of those are khabar. Allah has been mentioned in that verse how many times? 21 times. Lafdan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is more virtuous than any ayah in the Quran, because there is no verse in the Quran Allah has been mentioned his name, whether it be a ism zahir or whether it be Dhamir, either bariz or mustatir, nowhere has it been mentioned this much times except Ayatul Kursi. Now we go into, in terms of the meaning, Ayatul Kursi is a'zamu ayatin fi kitabillahi. It is the greatest ayah in the book of Allah. There is no ayah like it. Let's go to the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Allahu la ilaha illahu. Ayatul Kursi, it has 10 sentences in there. Asharata jumla. How many jumla are in Ayatul Kursi? Ashara, 10. Each jumla, we're going to stand over it. There are gems and there are benefits that can be taken out of it. How many jumla, how many sentences are in Ayatul Kursi? 10 jumla are in Ayatul Kursi. The first one is Allahu la ilaha illa hu. That's the first sentence. Allahu is what, brothers? Allah is lafdul jalala, a'raful ma'arif. The nuhad, they differ. Is Allah's name mushtaq or is it not mushtaq? Is it rooted from something or is it not? There are two views. We won't go into that right now. This is mabhath nahwi. We won't go into it. Allahu, Allah, la ilaha illahu. La ilaha, la is a nafi. The nafiya of la, it has to take an ism. The ism is la ilaha, ilaha is. Lakin where is the khabar? The khabar, the scholars, they say it's one of two. Either it's haqq,
Ama it's bihaq jar or majrur. Where do the scholars bring from saying haq or bihaq? Where do they bring it from? They bring it from the ayah ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه هو الباطل. Allah la ilaha illa ma'buda bihaqin ama la ma'buda haqun fil wujudi illahu. Those are the two which that are permissible for us to take. So we can say la ma'buda bihaqin fil wujudi illahu, or we can say la ma'buda haqun illahu. Both which are permissible for us to take. Allah la ilaha, that there is none worthy of worship in truth except him. The reason why we have to bring the word in truth, haq, is because there are things that are worshipped other than Allah. There are ilah besides Allah, but they're not haq. Allah says in the Quran, فَمَا أَغْنَتْ عَنْهُمْ آلِهَتُهُمُ الَّتِي يَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَا. Allah referred to the things that they're worshipping what? آلِهَا. So the things that the people are worshipping is ilah, but it's not haq. Who is haq? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why we bring the word, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقْ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ. La ilaha illallah, brothers, is the word, is the kalimatul tawheed. Allah sent the prophets and the messengers for this. As Allah said in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. That we did not send down, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ, we did not send down a messenger before you, except with what? إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ. This was what every Nabi and every Prophet was sent with. La ilaha illa illa ana fa'budun. Worship me alone. ولذلك the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? قولوا لا إله إلا الله تفلحوا. Say la ilaha illa Allah, you're going to find what? You're going to find success. ولذلك when the Prophet said قولوا لا إله إلا الله تفلحوا, and that Arabs, they understood that la ilaha illa Allah means la ma'buda بحق إلا الله. They understood it. They said, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَهُ وَاحِدًا إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عُجَابٌ. Did Muhammad make all of the idols into one? Meaning, did he make all of the ilah into one? Does he only want us to worship one ilah? They understood that he meant by لا إله إلا الله لا معبود بحق إلا الله. الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّومِ. Grammatically, there are two which permissible for us to grammatically take when it comes to the word الْحَيُّ. This is the second jumla now. اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ is the first jumla. The second jumla is what? Al-Hayyul al Qayyum. Al-Hayyul al Qayyum is the second jumla. How is it? Al-Hayy, there are two grammatical positions that we can take. The first one is we can say Al-Hayy is a badal of huwa. That's one. The second one that we can take is we could say that Hayy is a khabarun thanin li mubtada'in mahdhuf. We can say Al-Hayy is a khabarun thanin li mubtada'in mahdhuf. That hay is a subject. The mubtada is mahduf. What is the mubtada? Huwa al-hayyu la ilaha. Huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum, sorry. Huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. That's the second jumla, that's why. What does al-hayyu mean, brothers? Al-hayyu means the one who has the everlasting hayat. Allah and us, we all share hayat. Allah lives and we live. Lakin this is ishtirakun fil lafzi la ishtirakun fil haqiqah. We're sharing the name, not the sharing the reality. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, did not say in the Quran, يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَيُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ. We live. The hayat that we have, like in brothers, it differs with Allah in three ways. The first way is our hayat before it came Adam. We didn't exist. There was a time that we didn't exist. As for Allah, His hayat, there was no Adam, there was nothing, there was non-existent, there wasn't a time when it didn't exist. It always existed. He was always alive, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one is, our hayat is qasir, it's short. To a period of time, there's going to be a time that it's going to end. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. That every single one of us is going to come to an end, and Allah won't come to an end. كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَا. Everything is going to be destroyed except him. He's going to remain. So even you, your hayat is what? Qasir. It's restricted. It's short. It's only a limited of time. And the third one is, the hayat that you have was given to you. His one wasn't given to him. Your one was given to you. Allah gave it to you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-hayyu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alive. Everlasting. Will forever remain, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Hayyul Qayyum. Brothers, some of the scholars, they said Al-Hayyul Qayyum is Ismullah Al-A'zam. What does Ismullah Al-A'zam mean? It means إِذَا سُئِلَ بِهِ أَعْطَى. It's the name of Allah that if you ask Him, if you ask Allah on, based on this name, He'll give you what you ask for. ولذلك الإمام السيوطي رحمه الله جلال الدين السيوطي has a kitab called درر المنظم في علم الله الأعظم. درر الله المنظم في علم الله في أسماء الله الأعظم. سيوطي has a kitab, الرسالة مطبوع متداول. It's published. And he mentions 20 قولا. He mentions 20 different views regarding اسم الله الأعظم. لكن يا إخوة, the قول which is راجح is اسم الله الأعظم. It's not اسم جنس لمعين. No. It's not a specific name that is called اسم الله الأعظم. No. It's not. اسم الله الأعظم. First of all, Allah's اسماء are two types. An اسم, Allah's اسماء are two types. A اسم that has one or two meanings in it. That's it. Every اسم of Allah has a meaning in it because we believe Allah's names are what? أعلام باعتبار دلالته على الذات وأوصاف باعتبار دلالته على المعاني. Every name of Allah has a meaning in it. But some of Allah's names, they have one meaning in it. And that's the bare minimum. Some of them have two. Some of them have maybe 10, 15. And some of Allah's names, they have all of the names that go back to them. The ones that have all of the names of Allah go back to them are called Asma, Ismullah al-A'zam. Those are the ones. Are we all together, brothers? Any name which all of the names of Allah go back to is what, brothers? It is referred to as Ismullah al-A'zam. هذا هو القول الراجح. عند التحقيق, that's the مسألة. Because all of those views, how are you going to reconcile between them? And from the names of Allah, that all of the names go back to are Allah. The second one is Al-Hayyul Al-Qayyum. Those are names, all the names go back to. Because Al-Hayy is Sifa Dhatiya. And Al-Qayyum is Sifa Fi'liya. Every Sifa Dhatiya goes back to Al-Hayy. And every Sifa Fi'liya goes back to Al-Qayyum. Are we all together, brothers? Are we all together? Yes. So Ismullah al-A'zam is not Ismu Jins Mu'ayyanin. It's not a specific name. It's what, brothers? It's any Ism which all of the Asma of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come back to. So Allah is Al-Hayyul Al-Qayyum. We said Allahu La Ilaha. La Ilaha, we took what it means. La Ilaha, brothers, is what? أفضل ما قلت أنا والنبيون من قبلي. It is the best thing the Prophet said in the hadith. أفضل ما قلت أنا والنبيون من قبلي. It's the best thing that me and all the prophets who came before me, the best thing that we ever said, which is لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, until the ending. Al-Hayyu, what does it mean, brothers? The one who's ever living. Al-Qayyum means now, we're going to move on to Al-Qayyum. What does Al-Qayyum mean? Al-Qa'im بنفسه المقيم لغيره. Al-Qa'im بنفسه, the one who stands for himself. He doesn't need anyone to help him. He can do his own issues. Allah does not need help from anybody. He doesn't require anyone's support. Al-Qa'im بنفسه, he stands for his own affairs. Al-Muqim لغيره, and he stands for the affairs of others. He helps everybody. أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَى كُلِّ نَفْسٍ. Allah is the one who stands for the affairs of everybody. Everybody needs Allah, and everybody has the requirement of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. إذن Al-Qayyum, the scholars they mention, is مُبَالَغَة. From what? قائم. It's مبالغة قائم. Are we all together? قيوم is مبالغة. لكن عمر رضي الله عنه, as the ابن جرير, ابن أبي حاتم, ما وردي, ابن كثير and others, they mention it, ابن القيم mentions it, ابن تيمية mentions it, that عبد الله عمر ابن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه, he used to read القيوم as القيام. That's how عمر رضي الله عنه used to read it. He used to read الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيام. That's how we used to read it. Al-Qayyam and Al-Qayyum, Al-Qayyum ablaghu min Al-Qayyam. Al-Qayyum ablaghu min Al-Qayyam. Even though they have the same huruf and they have the same letters. Why? Because the qa'ida according to the grammarians is what? Wal-wawu aqwa min alifin. The waw is stronger than the alif. And this is another discussion for another time. So just Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. So Allahu la ilaha illa huwa is one sentence. The second jumla was what, brothers? Al-hayyu al-qayyum, bring the mubtada for it, who is missing. So you say, huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. That's the second sentence. Are we all together, brothers? The third one is, la ta'khuduhu sinatun wa la nawm. La ta'khuduhu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it doesn't take him. Sinatun. Sina, what does it mean? Sina, brothers, is muqaddamatun nawm. It's the introduction of sleeping. Before you go to sleep. Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi, he says in his tafsir, sinatun, what it means is that what happens to the eye, and an-nawm is what happens to the heart. If the person's eyes close, but they can still hear what's happening around them, this is called sinah. And if the person's heart shuts down, that they don't know what's happening around them, it's called nawm. Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi, that's what he says. Are we all together? لا تأخذه سنة. Allah, it doesn't take him سنة nor نوم. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم is a nafi. It's negating from Allah صفة نقص, deficiency. After affirming for Allah what? صفة كمال, which is الحي القيوم. According to أهل السنة والجماعة, and طريقة أهل السنة is that we do not do النفي المفصل. We don't do نفي المفصل and الإثبات المجمل. The opposite is true. The Quran, when you look at it, it comes with إثبات مفصل نفي مجمل. The Quran, when it negates from Allah deficiency, it doesn't name the deficiency. It doesn't say Allah doesn't have one eye, Allah is not. It doesn't list the things that Allah doesn't have. It just says لم يلد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد ليس كمثله شيء هل تعلم له سميا. Allah says it like that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The negation is general. But the ithbat in the Quran is always specific. Allah numbers the ithbat. The only times that the negation is actually named is when there's mentioned before it, ithbat mufassal. Does that make sense, brothers? The ithbat, if it's mufassal, then the nafi can be mufassal, no problem. Here Allah says, as-sinatun wala nawm. He named it. All he could have said is, that ليس كمثله شيء, there's nothing like him. Are we all together, brothers? Sina and Naum goes against Al-Hay. It's the opposite of Al-Hay, the one who's alive. How is it the opposite of Al-Hay? Sina, what did we just say, brothers? It's the muqaddima of what? Muqaddima to Naum, before you sleep. Okay, brothers? And a Naum is what? When you actually go to sleep. None of those two take Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because those two, they go against Haya. How does it go against Haya? Because sleeping is a form of what? Death. Allah says in the Quran, وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا جَرَحْتُمْ بِالنَّهَارِ وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ. Sleeping at night is actually death. You're going to death. How is it death? The comparison Ibn al-Qayyim mentions in his Bada'i al-Fawaid. How is it? When you're dying, what happens to you? Generally speaking, when a person is dying, illness overcomes the person, and then the person becomes sick, he gets a headache, and then he becomes fever and whatnot, and then the person dies. The same is with sleeping. Sina comes first, which the person is weak, and then the nawm actually comes. Are we all together, brothers? The sina is like the illness of what happens to a person who's dying. And then the nawm is the death, as the death when it comes to the person, before it is an illness that the person goes through. Am I making sense? Allah, none of those happen to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah lives, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't have no sinah wala nawm. But there are three things Allah told us that don't sleep. From the first one is the hadith in Tabarani in his Mu'jam al-Awsat, Bayhaqi narrated in Sunan al-Kubra, min hadith Jabir radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ayanamu ahli al-Jannah? Do the people of Jannah go to sleep? And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, an-nawmu akhul maut. Ahlul Jannah la yanamun. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, do the people in Jannah go to sleep? And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, an-nawmu sleeping is akhul maut, is the brother of death. Ahlul Jannah la yanamun. Al-Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah hassanahu fi sahih al-jami' wa sahahahu fi silsila hadith sahiha. That the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that the people of Jannah don't go to sleep. They don't sleep because sleeping is what, brothers? It's the brother of death. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran that the angels don't sleep. يُسَبِّحُونَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ لَا يَفْطُرُونَ. The angels, what do they know? They don't what? The angels don't sleep. Also in Sahih al-Muslim, it tells us the third one who doesn't sleep and never slept, never will sleep, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the hadith of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari in Sahih Muslim, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنَامْ وَلَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَنَامْ يَخْفَضُ الْقِسْطَ وَيَرْفَعُ يرفع إليه عمل الليل قبل عمل النهار وعمل النهار قبل عمل الليل حجابه النور وفي رواية حجابه النار لو كشفه لأحرقت سبحات وجهه ما انتهى إليه بصره من خلقه. إن الله لا ينام ولا ينبغي له أن ينام. Allah does not sleep and it doesn't befit him to sleep, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah doesn't sleep. nor do the angels sleep, and Ahlul Jannah don't sleep. That's لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Allah, it doesn't take him sinah and no. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. له for Allah تبارك وتعالى. له is a khabar, brothers. And the khabar came first. Ibn Malik told us in his Alfiyah, والأصل في الأخبار أن تؤخر وجوز التقديم إذ لا ضرر. That the asal of a khabar is that it's delayed. والأصل في الأخبار أن تؤخر وجوز التقديم إذ لا ضرر. If there's no harm in it. The asal of a khabar is that it falls after the mubtada. Here what happened is لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ. The khabar came first before the mubtada. And if this happens according to the balaghiyun, even the nuhat, is that if that takes place, يُفِيدُ الْحَصْرِ تَقْدِيمُ مَا حَقُّهُ التَّأْخِيرُ يُفِيدُ الْحَصْرِ. That's the qa'idah. تَقْدِيمُ مَا حَقُّهُ التَّأْخِيرُ يُفِيدُ الْحَصْرَ. To delay something that was meant to bring forward, it shows exclusivity. What's the exclusivity in there? Lahu, only for Allah. That's what we have to say. But it shocked me because when you look at the books of translation of the Quran, tafsir books, sorry, the Quran translation books, the overwhelming majority of them are wrong. Because what do they say here? Lahu ma fi samawati wa ma fil ardi. For Allah is what is in the samawat and the earth. They say something like this. That's wrong. What were they meant to say? For Him alone. They should have brought the word alone. Why? Because the tartibs changed here. The khabar came before the what? The mubtada. The ma'na, al-hasr, which is exclusivity. What does al-hasr mean? Al-ithbatu lil-madhkur wa nafyu amma adah. That's what hasr means, right? Affirming a ruling for something and negating everything else out of it. For Allahu ma fi samawati. For Allah is what is in the samawat. وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ and that which is in the earth. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari and Qurtubi and Ibn Kathir and others, they mention لَهُمَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ. For Allah is what is in the samawat, خَلْقًا وَمُلْكًا وَعَبِيدًا. Everything in the samawat is for Him. خَلْقًا, He created it. No one else created except Him. مُلْكًا, He's the king over them. وَعَبِيدًا, and all of them are His slaves. Nothing else is, they're all under Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He owns it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. For Him alone is that which is in the samawat and that which is in the earth, all of them are His. خَلْقًا, no one created them except Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمُلْكًا, He's the true king over them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا فَقَالَ لَا وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ. What's the ayah? وَيَوْمَ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ. لا من عيد اسمع عيدك لو لمن الملك اليوم لله الواحد قائد محوى يا what's the beginning of that? يومهم بارزون لا يخفى على الله منهم من لا يخفى على الله منهم شيء لمن الملك اليوم لله الواحد القهار. Allah will say to them, سبحانه وتعالى, لمن الملك اليوم, who's king, who owns the kingdom today, who's the true king today, but there's no one to respond. And then Allah says to himself, لله الواحد القهار, it's only for you, this is the true king. ملكاً وَعَبِيدًا إِن كُلُّ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِ الرَّحْمَانِ عَبْدًا. Everything in the samawat and everything in the earth are going to come to Allah. عَبْدًا, slave. He's the one who owns them. سبحانه. خَلْقًا وَمُلْكًا وَعَبِيدًا. لَهُمَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. This is the next jumla. We're going over jumla. So we took لَا تَأْخُذُهُ سِنَةٌ وَلَا نَوْمٌ, which was the third. Fourth was what? لَهُمَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَوْ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي, who is the one, يَشْفَعُ, who can do intercession, عِنْدَهُ, besides Allah, إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ, except with His what? With His permission. مَنْ ذَا, مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي, مَنْ, here is istifham, it's question, interrogation, who? Like in the scholars they say, here it's istifhamun bima'na al-nafi. Istifhamun bima'na al-nafi. It's a question, but in the context of a what? Negation. It's means لا أحد يشفع عنده إلا بإذني. Even though it's a question, but Allah is saying من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذني, أي لا أحد يشفع عنده إلا بإذني. No one can intercede except with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Are you with me, brothers? Because the شفاعة is for who? قل لله الشفاعة جميعا. All of the intercession is for who? All of the intercession is for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ولذلك the small matin that you should have all memorized, the small matin that you all should have memorized, al-qawa'id al-arba', the qa'idatu al-thaniya, what does he say? That ma da'unahum wa tawajjahna ilayhim illa li talabi al-qurbati wa shafa'a. Fadalilu al-qurba, what is it? والذين اتخذوا من دونه أولياء ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفى إن الله يحكم بينهم فيما هم فيه يختلفون إن الله لا يهدي من هو كاذب كفار. And the دليل الشفاعة is ويعبدون من دون الله ما لا يضرهم ولا ينفعهم ويقولون هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله قل أتنبئون الله بما لا يعلم في السماوات والأرض سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. And then he says, Muhammad Abdul Wahab, what does he say after that? وَشَفَاعَةُ شَفَاعَتَانِ شَفَاعَةُ مُثْبَتَةً شَفَاعَةُ مَنْفِيَةً شَفَاعَةُ مَنْفِيَةً is what? شَفَاعَةُ مَنْفِيَةً The negated شَفَاعَةُ is what? هي التي تطلب من غير الله. It is what is received or asked from other than Allah. هي التي تطلب من غير الله فيما لا يقدر عليه إلا الله. And he brings the ayah, يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ يَوْمٌ لَا بَيْعٌ فِيهِ وَلَا خُلَّةٌ وَلَا شَفَاعَةٌ وَالْكَافِرُونَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And then the shafa'ah muthbata, هي التي تطلب من الله والشافع مكرب والمشفوع له من رضي الله قوله وعمله بعد الإذن. And then he brings the ayah, من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذن. Then the shafa'ah is how many times, brothers? Two times. Shafa'ah manfiya, Allah negated it. And the shafa'ah muthbata, Allah affirmed it. The shafa'ah which is manfiya is the shafa'ah that's missing two things. Two things are missing. Any intercession that lacks two things, brothers, it's not going to be. There's no intercession here. What are they? Allah said it in Surah Al-Najm. وَكَمْ مِنْ مَلَكٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَا تُغْنِي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ يَأْذَنَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَرْضَى. Then we have إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ يَأْذَنَ اللَّهُ وَيَرْضَى. After that, صح. إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ يَأْذَنَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَرْضَى. صح. إذن والرضا. The إذن is that Allah gives permission. No one's allowed to intercede except Allah gives them permission. وَلِذَلِكَ نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدٍ who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's no one from the children of Adam greater and better than him. The day of judgment, the Prophet is going to pray prostrate under the arsh. The hadith of shafa'ah. He's going to prostrate under the arsh. And then he prostrates. And then he said, Allah is going to let me prostrate for how long he wants me to prostrate for. And then I'm going to lift, Allah is going to say to me, he's going to say, اِرْفَعَ رَأْسَكَ Muhammad, raise your head up. سَلْ تُعْطَى Ask, you're going to be given. Ishfa to shafa, intercede for your intercession will be taken into consideration. And then the messenger intercedes. He can't just intercede. He has to be given permission. Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even the kabair of Ahlul Jannah in the hadith, what does he say? وَيُحَدِّدُ لِي رَبِّي حَدَّى He says, my Lord will set for me a had. The kabair, the people, believers who have done major sin that need to be taken out of Jannah. When Allah is taking them out of Jannah, He goes, Allah sets for me boundaries that I have to observe. Nabiullah Muhammad is saying that. So then how can a person today do I can intercede on your behalf and Fulan can intercede on your behalf? And Nabiullah Muhammad is being given permission to intercede. He can't even just intercede. The second condition is, وَيَرْضَى Allah is pleased. And Allah is pleased with two people. الشَّافِعْ وَالْمَشْفُوعِ لَهُ الشَّافِعْ وَالْمَشْفُوعِ لَهُ Shafi' is the one who is doing the intercession. وَالْمَشْفُوعِ لَهُ And the one who the intercession is being done for. Are we all together, brothers? Allah has to be pleased with the one who is doing it. And the one who is being done for Allah has to be pleased with them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are we all together, brothers? And the ones who Allah is pleased with is the believers. Like there's an istithna here, hadith ibn Abbas in Sahih Muslim, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he done intercession for Abu Talib. Abu Talib has an intercession. And he's the only exception in the equation. That the Messenger interceded for him, that Allah reduced the hellfire for him, and Abu Talib is going to wear two shoes. يَغْلَى بِهِمَا دِمَاغُهُ His head's going to boil from it. His hellfire got reduced. And that's through the Messenger's what? Intercession, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then here, what do we say? مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ No one can intercede and give intercession إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ أَيْ إِلَّا مَقْرُونًا بِإِذْنِهِ Except if it's connected to the permission of Allah with it. يَعْلَمُ Allah knows. مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows. مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ That which is in front of them. Allah knows it subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does it mean, مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ The Mufassirin have two qawl. مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ The Mufassirin have two qawl. The first qawl is, مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ أي مِنْ أَمْرِ الدُّنْيَا Matters of the dunya. And another qawl is, أي مِنْ أَمْرِ الْآخِرَةِ That's the second qawl. Which is the opposite. وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ There's two قول وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ means what? مِنْ أَمْرِ الْآخِرَةِ And the second قول is مِنْ أَمْرِ الدُّنْيَا And the قول that is strongest is that the first one is مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ is أَمْرُ الْآخِرَةِ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ is أَمْرَ مِنْ أَمْرِ الدُّنْيَا. Why? Because every one of us مُسْتَقْبِلٌ لِلْآخِرَةِ مُسْتَدْبِرٌ لِلْدُّنْيَا. All of us is what? مُسْتَقْبِلٌ لِلْآخِرَةِ. We're facing the آخِرَةِ. مُسْتَدْبِرٌ عَنِ الدُّنْيَا. But we're turning away from the dunya. So that's why it makes stronger sense that to say مِنْ بَيْنِ مَا يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ, to say that it's what? مِنْ أَمْرِ الْآخِرَةِ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ is what? مِنْ أَمْرِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ, they do not encompass بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ, anything from His knowledge subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ, except that which He wishes subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ, they do not encompass, وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ, no one can encompass Allah's knowledge. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ, there's two قول بِعِلْمِهِ here. The first one is بِعِلْمِهِ, the word ilm, it comes in the wazn of fi'l. And the Arabs, they have that if a word comes in the wazn of fi'l, it can turn into maf'ul. Are we all together? Like ذِبْح, مَذْبُوح. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. So man, isn't it بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ? Ha. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ أي بِمَذْبُوحٍ عَظِيمٍ. That's what it means. So here they said, وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ مَعْلُومَاتِهِ, that they do not encompass anything from the knowledge Allah has subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are we all together, brothers? That's one qawl. The way that ذِبْح is مَذْبُوح, and نِسِّ is مَنْسِي, and نِضْح is مَنْضُوح, like that. The second qawl is that وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ means أي مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ أي ذَاتِهِ, no one knows Allah تبارك وتعالى, no one has knowledge of Him except that which He allows you to know of Him. Are we all together? That's the second qawl. أي ذَاتُهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, no one knows Allah except that which He wants Him to know about Him. Because brothers, to know something how it is, it have to be from two ways. Either we have to see that thing, and no one has seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one is something that we can compare Allah to, and there's nothing to compare Him to subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those two avenues to know things are not there for us. So the only avenue that's open for us is what He tells us of Himself. Are we all together, brothers? So we only know of Him, وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ أي بِذَاتِهِ, no one encompass knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ, except that which He wants you to know of Him. Are we all together, brothers? So you can only know of Allah that which He told you of Himself. There's no other way you can know. So when you affirm a characteristic for Allah, you have to say where you got it from. If you negate a characteristic from Allah, you have to tell us where you got this from. Because a nephew, what does it require? It requires a prior knowledge to it. And then and the ithbat requires a prior knowledge. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ, then everything Allah has encompassed in knowledge subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no one who has knowledge of everything. Not like what is written in the kitab al-fuyudat al-rabbaniyah, they call it. فِي الْأَوْرَادِ al-qadiriyyah. They have a kitab where inside there's a line which he says, وَأَعْلَمُ عِلْمَ اللَّهِ أُحْصِي حُرُوفَهُ وَأَعْلَمُ عِلْمَ اللَّهِ, I have the knowledge of Allah, أُحْصِي حُرُوفَهُ, all of the حُرُوف of Allah, and everything that He's created, I have encompassed it. That's batil. No one knows. And as Bursiri says in his Burda, وَإِنَّ مِنْ جُودِكَ الدُّنْيَا وَضَرَّتِ وَمِنْ عُلُومِكَ عِلْمَ اللَّوْحِ وَالْقَلَمِ, from your knowledge, the limh, unseen, everything, no one knows it, يا إخوان. عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ فَلَا يُظْهِرُ عَلَى غَيْبِهِ أَحَدًا, Allah doesn't tell His knowledge to everybody. قُلْ لَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ غَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, no one knows it. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, قُلْ لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ وَلَوْ كُنْتُ أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبَ لَاسْتَكْثَرْتُ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ وَمَا مَسَّنِيَ السُّءِ. The Prophet is saying this. So no one knows the unseen except that which Allah wants you for you to know. وَلِذَلِكَ in the Hadith Sahih al-Bukhari, the Messenger ﷺ, at the Day of Judgment, is going to see a people be brought to him. A people are going to be brought to his fountain, alayhi salatu wasalam, and they want to come close to him. And then they get pushed away from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, my ummah. And then it will be said to him, innaka la tadri ma ahdathu ba'da. Like, innaka la tadri, you don't know. Knowledge has been negated from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Innaka la tadri, Muhammad, you don't know. Ma ahdathu ba'daka, that which they did after you. So that shows you that the Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his knowledge is not that he knows everything. He only knows what Allah wants him to know, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, as for Allah, Allah knows everything. Allah knows what has happened. Allah knows what's happening. Allah knows what's going to happen. If it was to happen, how it would have happened. Are you with me, brothers? And there are many ayats in the Quran that show Allah knows the things that don't have, it won't happen, it hasn't happened. Allah knows. Any place in the ayat of the Quran where you find low is being used. Allah said, قُلْ لَوْ يَعْلَى, he says in the ayah, بَلْ بَدَى لَهُمَا كَانُوا يُخْفُونَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنُوا وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَذِبُونَ وَلَوْ رُدُّوا, but they haven't been brought back. But Allah knows, لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنُوا وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَذِبُونَ. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the ayah, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَوْلَا أَنْ يَكُونَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً لَجَعَلْنَا لِمَنْ يَكْفُرُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ لِبُيُوتِهِمْ سُقْفًا مِنْ فِضَّةٍ وَمَعَارِجَ عَلَيْهَا يَظْهَرُونَ وَلِبُيُوتِهِمْ أَبْوَابٌ وَسُرُرًا عَلَيْهَا يَتَّكِئُونَ وَزُخْرُفًا وَإِنْ كُلُّ ذَلِكَ لَمَّا مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This hasn't happened. لَوْ كَانَ فِيهِمَا آلِهَةٌ إِلَّا اللَّهُ لَفَسَدَتَهَا. This is not, hasn't happened. All of these things Allah is saying are, it's not happening, but if it was to happen, he knows how it's going to be, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then brothers, it's not that he only knows, but it's also documented for him. وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّهُ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَمَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ وَلَا رَطْبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Everything is written for him. We forget what we did, the sins that we committed, and the crimes that we've committed. وَلِذَلِكَ the poet, he said, لَمْ يَنْسَهُ الْمَلَكَانِ حِينَ نَسِيتَهُ بَلْ أَثْبَتَاهُ وَأَنْتَ لَهِ تَلْعَبُ. لَمْ يَنْسَهُ الْمَلَكَانِ حِينَ نَسِيتَهُ. When you chose to forget it, the angels didn't choose to forget it. بَلْ أَثْبَتَاهُ, they chose to document it. بَلْ أَثْبَتَاهُ وَأَنْتَ لَاهِنْ, and you were playing, and you were joking. بَلْ أَنْتَ لَاهِنْ تَلْعَبُ, while you were joking and you were laughing. The angels didn't choose to forget it, nor did they choose to dismiss it. They wrote it. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيمٌ عَتِيدٌ. Allah says that everything, وَمَا تَكُونُ فِي شَأْنٍ وَمَا تَتْلُو مِنْهُ مِنْ قُرْآنٍ وَلَا تَعْمَلُونَ مِنْ عَمَلٍ إِلَّا كُنَّا عَلَيْكُمْ شُهُودًا إِذْ تُفِيضُونَ فِيهِ. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَيَقُولُ سُورَةُ قَاف لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدٌ. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Everything to him is known, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ pay attention to this. Nabiullah Musa, who did he come to? When he said, he was asked, and he said, I'm the most knowledgeable person. And they said, go to a man who's more knowledgeable than you. Who did he go to? He went to Khadir. And what did he say to Khadir? قَالَ لَهُ مُوسَى هَلْ أَتَّبِعُكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُعَلِّمَنِي مِمَّا عُلِمْتَ رُشْتَ. قَالَ إِنَّكَ لَن تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. So Nabiullah Musa went to Khadir. In Sahih al-Bukhari, Khadir said to Musa alayhi salam, مَا نَقَصَ عِلْمِي وَعِلْمُكَ مِنْ عِلْمِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا كَنَقْرَةِ هَذَا الْعُصْفُورِ فِي الْبَحْرِ. Musa and Khadir, Khadir looked at Musa and he said to him, my knowledge and your knowledge, and they're the most knowledgeable men on the face of the earth that day. No one is more knowledgeable than both of them. Musa and Khadir, two prophets of Allah. He said, my knowledge and your knowledge is like a bird puts its peck inside the water and it picks water. How much water can he take from the ocean? Our knowledge is like that, what we've just taken from the ocean, and Allah's knowledge is the ocean. صح؟ إذن وفوق كل ذي علم عليم. Everyone who has knowledge, Allah is more knowledgeable than subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. This is now knowing that Allah knows all of that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It brings the person khashya, and it makes them scared and worried. وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's kursi has become vast over the samawat and the ard. This is the second, this is another jumla. The scholars, they said, wasi'a kursiyuhu. What is kursiyuhu here? There are four qawl, four views. The first one is, kursiyuhu is qawl, is ilm, Allah's knowledge. Allah's knowledge is vast over everything. This qawl is attributed to Ibn Abbas. Some scholars, they weaken this authenticity. Some of scholars, they what? They weakened it. And لكن ال Imam Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he took this view and he strengthened it. He said, وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ بِزْعِلْمُهُ, Allah's knowledge. And this is the qawl Ibn Jarir al-Tabari took. The second view is, وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ, كُرْسِيُّهُ means مُلْكُهُ, Allah's kingdom. The third qawl is, كُرْسِيُّهُ is a creation. It's a creation that is smaller than the arsh, but it's greater than the samawat and the ard. Rather, the narration mentioned, Hakim narrates in his Mustadrak, and Imam al-Dhahabi agrees with it, with him, and Sheikh Albani authenticates it, that it is the arsh is in size compared to the kursi, like a needle thrown into an open land. How is that like? The arsh is that big compared to the kursi. And the kursi is like that compared to the earth. The samawat and the ard, all of them. The kursi is bigger than them, like the arsh is bigger than the kursi. This hadith is sahat marfu'an, is sahih marfu'an. The fourth qawl is a qawl which is attributed to Abdullah ibn Abbas himself, where he said that the kursi is mawdu'u qadamayi rabb. It's Allah's where he places his feet, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the fourth qawl. Mawdu'u qadamayn, the place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places his foot, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a footstool for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is it? We say that we don't know the how of Allah's characteristics. It is in a way that befits his what? It befits his majesty, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the qawl which is rajih is that the kursi, we can't dive. Ibn Jarir, his tarjih here is weak. Because why? وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ, it's diverting it from the ظاهر وَالْأَصْلُ فِي الْكَلَامِ. The asl of the kalam is what, brothers? The asl of the kalam is what? الْحَقِيقَة. The asl of the kalam is to leave it is حَقِيقَة in its real manner. The majaz, it's only come with when there's a qareena inside the sentence. And there's no qareena for him to have to take the majaz right now. Are we all together? الْأَصْلُ فِي الْكَلَامِ الْحَقِيقَة. We would have tried to reconcile between these views, but they can't be reconciled. Maraqi Sa'ud, what did he say in his kitab? He says, وَالْجَمْعُ وَاجِبٌ مَتَى مَا أَمْكَنَا إِلَّا فَلِلْأَخِيرِ نَسْقٍ بُيِّنَا. وَالْجَمْعُ وَاجِبٌ مَتَى مَا أَمْكَنَا. If we can reconcile between the views, we will try our best. وَالْجَمْعُ وَاجِبٌ مَتَى مَا أَمْكَنَا. If we're able to do it. إِلَّا فَلِلْأَخِيرِ نَسْقٍ بُيِّنَا. Or else we will dismiss the other views and we'll say that this view is the right, most correct. وَلَا يَؤُوذُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing overweighs لا يثقله. The word وَلَا يَؤُوذُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا أَيْ لَا يَشُقُّ عَلَيْهِ أَمَا لَا يُثْقِلُهُ. Nothing burdens Allah and pressures Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in protecting the samawat and the earth. No. There's nothing heavy on him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. Ali, brothers, it has three things in it. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, Al-Ali istighraqiyya. So it has all three of them. Uluu dhatin wa uluu qahrin wa uluu qadrin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has those three uluu. Wa huwa al-Ali, when we say it, we mean uluu dhatin. He, Allah, is above his throne. Because al-uluu here, al-hiya, is what? Istighraqiyya, encompass all three. Anyone who does takhsis and says, no, it's only one of those three, has to be evidence. Because it says al-uluu, all of uluu is for him. If you say, no, there's part of ulu for Allah and there's another part of ulu that's missing, to show that can't be the case, Al-Azim has the same of the three that is ulu is in Azim as well. And they won't say that it's one of them. Because Allah has, His Azama is Dhatuhu, Wa Qadruhu, Wa Qahruhu. Are we all together, brothers? What does each one mean? Ulu Dhatin means Allah is above His throne. Uluu qadrin means Allah is, His honor is greater than anyone's honor. Uluu qahrin means Allah's strength and power and might is greater than everyone's might. All three of those are in uluu. Are we all together, brothers? Azim has the three inside it as well. The azama which is that, and the azama which is connected to Allah's qadr, and the azama which is connected to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's qahr, all three of them are in them. So when it comes to the ulu, you say, no, 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 ulu, that is not in there. Allah is not above his throne. But then when it comes to azim, you would say, no, Allah is azimu fi dhatihi. Are we all together, brothers? So this is a halalun ala balabirihi dawhu halalun littayri min kulli jinsi. Sah? It is contradiction. It's a contradiction. Ba'i tajurru wa ba'uka la tajurru. Sah? Ba'i tajurru. My back could do jar on your, like in ba'uka la tajurru. We'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaitan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.